Miners, today I will show you some information about dual mining and which currencies you can mine with Ethereum, and if it's beneficial to mine a second currency, or if it's not worth it. Here I have the website from WhatToMine, and you can see. For the Ethereum, there are a couple of currencies you can use for the dual mining, and I will show you the prices for each one and also some information. So the first one is the DCR. So the DCR is have a good price, as you can see from World Coin Index, and at the moment is £68. That's a British pound. And it's moving, it's going up for the last month, and but the last 3 months is around end of March we had the big drop for all the currencies, but now it's higher than it used to be. So this year is a good currency for dual mining, but the problem is if you mine Ethereum and you want to also mine this year, it's going to increase the voltage and the watts, also the temperature. So I will show you how to dual mine this year. I have the configuration, but when I try, I have my rig have six cards, six AMD cards. At the moment it's using about 700 watts. So when I did dual mining with this year, it increased to 1100. Also the temperature increased a lot. So even if with the latest Ethos and the latest Claymore 11.6, I think they advertise that you can do dual mining, you don't sacrifice your Ethereum. Okay, you don't sacrifice, but if you increase your electricity to double, and also if you increase the power, then you need extra funds. You need to drop the Paratune. Then, at the end of the day, you will see that it probably is not worth it. If you do the calculation, you want to mine. So, for example, I will use in my case for Ethereum. I have 170 megahash. The pool fee is 1%. And then, let me change to this year. So go again. 170, 1%. So when I mine with DCR without changing the power tune, I could mine 1.2 gigahash. Pool fee is 1%. I was using let me see what was the name. This is the configuration which I will explain you later. So I was using Supernova. Yeah, so Supernova is a good pool for the DCR. So I think it's 1 or 2%, I don't remember, but at the moment I would just leave it as it is. So my voltage, I would just put 1000. Let's see. So as you can see here, monthly reward or even annual reward for this year is 0.1. It's not worth it, as you can see here. The revenue will be $260. $86 will be the cost. Probably will be more than that. So the extra power and the extra effort on the cards is not worth it, at least to mine DCR, but I will show you also other currencies. So another currency is the Pascal coin. This coin is good for mining. They advertise that it doesn't use a lot of power. Probably some people on the internet, they just saw that the watts increase only 10 between 10 and 15%, but I didn't try Pascal coin yet. But some people they did, and they didn't see a big increase like this year. Another co good coin is Library Credit, but the value is also very low and it is not very stable. As you can see here, it's just going up and down. So it's not very stable currency. If you want stability and kind of fixed income. On the other side, Pascha coin, it used to be very good. It used to be, but also dropped a lot. Max coin as well. So also the value is very low. So maybe it's not worth it. But as you can see here, increase a lot. So if you have max coin, if you have a couple of max coins and you see a jump like that, obviously you double your money. Smart cash, let's see, smart cash. No, ma the volume, the price is very low. Again, it used to be much better place, but it was just a jump in January, the end of December, beginning of January, the big jump where everyone was mining like crazy. Everyone was buying graphic cards. Graphic cards increased to $800 for 4 gig, and then it just went back to normal. So probably it's not worth it as well. So let's see, Virgin. The same low price. It's not a big price, but so don't expect a big income. Sia coin, that's very low, and also is going down. It's like 5%, so probably is not worth it. And the last one is Pascal Lite. So Pascal Lite with Pascal coin, both are quite, they are very good because this currency doesn't push the graphic cards too much, so you don't increase your electricity. Probably you just increase a little bit, but if you have to choose between the two, Pascal coin is much better. So yeah, from all these currencies, from my research I did on the internet and from other people, they have websites, they explain, and also they show the results. The coins that probably worth to mine again is Pascal coin or Pascal Lite. So you have to try both and see which one is better. But this year I did try, and with AMD cards, RX 580s, 4 gig, it doesn't work. This increases the watts by 500 watts extra, and you have to drop the party, so you have to sacrifice 30 to 40 Ethereum megahash to add the DCR, which would not give you, would give you only 0.1 a year. I think it was 0.1, yeah, 0.2 a year. It's better to mine Bitcoin. Okay, so these are the currencies which are available at the moment for dual mining. So again, the reason I'm introduce you the dual mining is because with the new Ethos 131 and the new Claymore, they advertise that you can dual mine without affecting your primary currency. And also you don't overkill your graphic cards. Okay, so now I will show you the configuration I use for the DCR. So this is from the local file. The first part is the main mining. Also, I will put the configuration in the description page in YouTube, so you can copy from there if you want to. So the main mine is we just leave it as this, Stratum proxy enable. This is the proxy wallet for the primary currency. In my case, this is my Ethereum wallet address. I'm using Proxypool for Ethermine. So these are my Proxypool 1 and 2 for Europe. And these are the flags which Ethos have as a default in the config file. So as you can see, I commented because for dual mining you cannot use these flags, otherwise the system will be very unstable, so you have problems. Global mining is Claymore, and this part is the dual mining, that's for the second currency. So you have to activate dual miner enabled. Here you have to specify the coin, DCR or Pascal, or it depends which currency you're going to use. And then for the new currency you have to find two things. One is the pool and the address, your wallet address. So in my case I register with Supernova, and Supernova is a good pool because for example, for the DCR, you download your DCR wallet in your PC. There is a software for Mac, for example, where you can download it and you can have it offline. It takes a while to synchronize, but it's a good application. So when you generate your wallet address, you go to the Supernova after the registration, and then you add your wallet address there. So since you have your wallet address in Supernova, you don't need to put your wallet address here. So here, actually, I just copy paste, but here you put your pool username. Okay, so when you go to Supernova, I don't know if it's the same for a Pascal related pools, but for Supernova, when you register, you get a username. So you just put the pool username here and the pool password, and you don't put your wallet. Your wallet will stay in Supernova. Maybe I'll connect to Supernova, I will show you. And at the end you put the flags. These are the flags, so the family check is the same, but as you can see here the global walk is much higher because we have, of course, two coins, so you have to double the value. So with this flag, I could mine with the same hash in Ethereum plus 1.2 gigahash with DCR. So this is the configuration, which I also put in YouTube, so you don't have to write it down. Just you can copy from there. And now I will show you the DCR pool, so you can have an idea how it looks like. So this is a Supernova. So I just need to log in. Okay. So if you mine with DCR, keep in mind that we take a while until you see your hash rate here. So I was mining for about an hour, but the only I've seen was just that at the bottom here, the red line. So other people they reported that it takes a while, so don't expect fast results. So when you register, you can see here the hash, the pool hash, the workers, net hash, the Bittrex, the value. So this is the dashboard, obviously, and also here you can see Stratum. But I use, as you can see from my configuration, I use this 3252, which is this pool here, this year. I believe it is this one. Oh, this year hyphen ZW. Is it? Yeah. Yeah, it's not here. This is for Windows. So let me show you now the account. Inside the account, I think it's in the account. Statistics, pull blocks. Okay. So when you are in the account, you have to create your worker. So worker name, you can put anything, and here you put a password, and this is the worker login. So yeah, the worker password is this, but anyway, you can change. At the moment, I'm not using it. So the worker login is this. So this is what you're going to put, both this name dot and your worker login. With this worker login, you can find it from your from your Ethos. Let me show you. So as you can see, my Ethos is, when you log in, you can see your Ethos, your working number and or name. So this you take and you put it here in the worker login. You create your password, and then you update, and then automatically this become active. So since this is active, we can add it in the config file. And transactions, no. And somewhere here you put the pool. Yeah, this one. So you have to go to my account. You have the API key also, if you want to use API. And here you put the payment address, that's your wallet address, and you can specify if you want to give a donation, good for you. And here you can put how much you want to have the threshold. The good is you can start from 0.1 if you want fast payments, or you can leave it as this. I think the default one is 0.10. So this is how you set up the Supernova. But again, this is for DCR. If you want to mine other currency, probably you have to use another pool. So yeah, this is an update generally for the new Ethos with new Claymore and the dual mining. So if you're planning to dual mine, think carefully, do your calculations, and don't just start mining any currency, because if at the end of the day you make $5 a month, but you spend double electricity, it's not worth it. So my advice is, if you have AMD cards, try DCR just to see how it works, and to have a just to see how your electricity and how your graphic cards are going to work, how hard they're going to work for the DCR. But also try the other currencies, probably Pascal, because looks like are more efficient than DCR. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned.